Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com, in the 2018-19 boys basketball season, the Poly Engineers of Coach Sam Brand with 22-5, their fourth straight 20-win season. They finished number two in the Varsity Sports Network top 20 and won a third straight Class 3A championship. Amazingly, that's the first time any boys team in the state has gone back-to-back-to-back in Class 3A. The 1999 graduate of Poly has turned the engineers program around. Two city titles, four region titles, and again, three straight Class 3A championships. And Sam Brand is our 2018-19 Varsity Sports Network Boys Basketball Coach of the Year. And Coach, just talk about going into the season. So much expectations. Very lofty goals you guys had.
It's... As your program grows, things change and you make adjustments and you take on new challenges. So being the underdog was a big part of our spirit and who we were as a program before. But you know, now with our success over the past few years, we are expected to win. We are the favorites. We have to deal with teams that are hungry to take our spot instead of us being that hungry team. And I was real proud with the way the guys handled it and our staff handled challenging the guys with that task and responsibility of having those kind of expectations and goals. You know, the reality is that even this season, with all the success we have, we are just in the frame of mind here as we know we can do better. We know we can do more. We want to do more. So I think it really starts with having a culture of wanting to do better and wanting to achieve at your highest level, which guys that have come along the way here have established. And then these guys, no matter how well the guys do before, the next guy's like, well, I want to do more. I want to do more than John did. I want to do more than Jordan did. I want to do more than Dre and Demetrius and now Amani, and then it'll be Justin and Ryan, and you know, all our guys, Brandon, all our guys. Ian, as you saw, we were talking about, has three state championships. Like, these guys are leaving a legacy, and we have a great group of guys to carry it on.
Yeah. Talk about just what you guys have done from the beginning, because when you first came in, you had a goal. You had a vision. A lot of people probably said, come on, Sam, you can't do this. It's Poly. Poly has no basketball pedigree. Poly, you know, when I'm coming up, I've known Poly for all the great success in football with Augie Wobble. I mean, kind of talk about that. Just kind of overcoming so many obstacles to be able to bring Poly to where it is now, arguably the number one basketball program in Baltimore.
You know, overcoming those obstacles and those challenges, it's what myself and our staff were all about. I mean, the first part about... So what you just described was establishing a culture, and that was our challenge when we first got here. What is the culture of Poly basketball going to be under myself, Fitz, and our entire staff? A group of Poly guys were coming back to take over the program. You know, it was really important in the first few years that we established culture. What exactly does this program represent? What are we about? No question, our first piece in that process was establishing a system of academic support and a system of accountability with using that academic support. So we had guys, when I first got here, nobody was even academically qualified to get a scholarship if they were that good. We had a 1.3 team GPA. So it was really, initially it was just, let's establish a culture where we have guys realize, look, it's gonna take a lot to be a student athlete at Poly. And we're here to support you in doing that. So the level of support for our guys off the court was the first thing we had to establish, and we knew that they would appreciate it and appreciate who we were to them moving forward to establish that culture and pass that culture on to the next group. So, you know, I was lucky enough to have some great people to start the program with. We shared a common vision. We established a culture with a great group of kids, and it's just been passed along and improved upon. The staff has improved. The talent level here has improved. And it's been... it's been a joy to be a part of and to be able to do it with, you know, my close friends.
Yeah, and kind of go back to last season. You guys were the favorite to win the city championship. He did not make that goal. He lost a great game to Patterson. A disappointing loss, fair to say. Yeah. But you guys were able to rebound. Kind of talk about overcoming that adversity. And following up on adversity, you guys kind of feed off of that. I think you guys kind of, and I've written several times how I think you kind of enjoy kind of having that adversity to kind of use that as a learning tool for your young men.
Yeah, I think that that our, you know, you don't get better from not challenging yourself. You don't get better from taking the easy road. You don't get better from playing the least competition. You get better from going through, and you find out who you really are when you go through some rough stuff. Now, look, I'd rather have won that game and move forward from that. But, you know, the truth is maybe we don't learn a lesson that we learned in that game. We wind up losing to St. Francis a couple weeks later. You know, our motto is that true character is revealed in times of adversity. It's something we live by, and we know, you know, I tell the guys, like, we're going to go through stuff together. And I don't know exactly what that stuff's going to be in every year, but we can go undefeated. We're still going to have our issues. Who we are through those issues, how we handle adversity is going to speak to who we are as a team and who we are as people. And I'm just real proud the way our program and our guys, like, as you said, it's something we've gotten used to. We accept the, you know, us against everybody mentality, and we, you know, we work hard to make sure we can achieve, you know, at a high level when we take on those challenges.
Well, in 9 seasons at his alma mater, Baltimore Polytechnic Institute, Sam Brand is 159-68. He has 2 city titles, 4 region titles, and 3 Class 3A state championships. They went 22-5 this past season. Number 2 ranking in Varsity Sports Network's final top 20. And for that, Sam Brand is our 2018-19 Varsity Sports Network Boys Basketball Coach of the Year. Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you. I appreciate Varsity Sports Network for their coverage. Since I've been doing this, you guys have been great, man. I appreciate you guys.
All right. Thanks a lot, Coach. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Toney.